Okay, so good day everyone. So we're now in our next lesson. This is lesson 4 in PE Math Pit 3. So we're now entering the realm of martial arts. Okay. Now, if we will try to define martial arts are codified system and transition of combat practice for a number of reasons such as self-defense, military and law enforcement, application, competition, physical, mental, and spiritual development. Okay, it's also used for entertainment and the preservation of a nation's intangible cultural heritage. Okay, so it is a tradition that is practiced, okay, either for self-defense, for military training or law enforcement training, competition or in sport, okay, or pwede rin siyang pang physical lang, pang para exercise, pang meditation, okay, and spiritual development, sometimes entertainment, which is applied in movies. Okay, so the origin of martial arts can be traced through the depiction of figurative art. So martial art is an art. Okay, in ancient literature and archaeological discoveries dating back to 3000 BCE, okay, with a significant influence from Asia. So tendency, when you talk about martial arts, nag-iikot lang yan talaga sa Asia, particularly in country, the country like China, okay, which is renowned in martial arts, okay, like kung fu, okay, and karate, where dun po nag-originate. Engaging in martial arts often offers a path to increased activity. Okay, so, kasi iba yung exercise, iba yung nagperform ka ng martial arts. Kasi medyo mas directed yung movement nito. At hindi lang siya pang physical, more on mental. At na-apply mo to by means of self-defense skills and discipline living. So, pag ikaw ay nag-aaral martial arts, medyo mataas ang level of discipline. Discipline mo. Okay? Here, we present the finest martial arts nationwide. Okay, so, martial arts is a popular choice for various reasons. Okay, so, bakit nga ba gusto mag-aral ng martial arts? Maaring self-defense, pang-fitness, enrichment, okay? Okay, so, ano yung mga maaring kunin natin ang pag-aralan ng martial arts? Okay, meron tayong judo, okay? Mamaya malalaman natin kung ano yung mga yan. We have karate, kung fu, taekwondo, muay thai, and wushu. Okay? Among the list. Okay? For those seeking inspiration, okay, we present the top 10 martial artists globally. Okay? That will be on another lesson. Okay? Now, martial arts can be any various fighting sports skill. Okay? Mainly of East Asia origin. Such as kung fu or pyongying yung fu, judo, karate, and kendo. Okay, so what are the different types of martial arts? Okay, so alam ko marami na kayong alam. So let's get a deeper understanding and knowledge about these martial arts. First one, we have karate. Okay, so sa Tagalog, tawag natin karate, but it's pronounced as karate. Is an unarmed martial arts discipline employing kicking, striking, and defensive blocking with arms and legs. Emphasis is on concentrating as much of the body's power as possible at the point and instant of impact. So, ang karate is more on a force, okay, or a power technique. Striking surfaces includes the hand, okay, particularly the knuckles and the outer edge. So, we say knuckles and outer edge. Okay. And ball of the foot, heel, forearm, knee, and elbow. So, all the parts of your body is being utilized, okay, in karate. All are toughened by practice blow against padded surface or wood. So, paano napapatibay yan? Napapatigas? Okay. Talagang pinapraksya, sinusuntok sa wood, sinusuntok sa padded frame. Nung time ko, okay, mayroon kaming bakanting lote before, okay, yung Tag mo yung puno ng saging. Yun ang pinagpapraktisa namin. Pine boards up to several inches in thickness can be broken by karate by the bare hands. Naghahati ng mga boards. Okay? Whether using the hand or the foot. Okay? Pero parang wala man yata akong alam na yung noo ginaganon. Okay, so timing, tactics, and spirit, however, are each considered at least important as physical toughening. So, ito, more on aggressive. Talagang hard technique po siya. Okay. In sporting karate and sparring, or called komite, okay, in training, blows and kicks are stopped short, preferably within an inch of contact. Okay. Sporting matches commonly last about 3 minutes. So, pag we're talking about now as a sport na ha, okay, hindi yung nakikipaglaban ka sa labas. Okay, so to a decision, if neither contestant has scored a clean killing, okay, when we say killing, okay, kaya may quotation mark po yan, okay, yun ang tawag niya, ibig sabihin, parang knockout na. It doesn't mean naman na kailangan siya ay todas na. Okay, in estimation of the judge, contest of form, known as kata, are also held. Kata, ibig sabihin, hindi naman karate, meron pang isang klaseng competition kung saan hindi naman naglalaban. Kumbaga nagkakaroon ng demonstration, pinapakita mo yung kata, yung movements, are also held in a single competition performed, predetermined series of movements. So, yan ha, simulating defense and counterattack against several opponents. You will have your own kata. Okay? Performances are scored by a panel of judges as in gymnastics. So, karate evolved in East Asia over a period of centuries, becoming systematized in Okinawa in the 17th century. So, saan po? Siyempre, sa Japan. Okay, in the 17th century. Probably by people forbidden to carry weapon. Bakit nila raw na-develop yan? Kasi, dati sa Japan, pwede kang maglakad ng may dalang samurai o kung anong weapon, face bat, na merong mga tao hindi allowed. Okay, so in order for them to defend themselves, they develop, okay, this form of martial arts. Okay, it was imported into Japan in the 1920s. Several schools and systems developed, each favoring somewhat different techniques and training methods. Karate, like other Asian martial arts discipline, stresses mental attitude. Okay, rituals of courtesy, costumes and complex ranking by collar or belt, okay? There is overlapping of techniques with other fighting styles. Okay, so parang nag-overlap siya. Pero remember, when you talk about karate, mainly focus siya sa unarmed combat. Okay? At generally, kadalasan yan ay sa kamay. Okay, so that is karate. Okay. Next, we have Aikido. Aikido. Okay. Aikido, okay, martial arts is a self-defense system. Okay. Some self-defense system that resembles the fighting method jiu-jitsu and judo, okay, in its use of twisting and throwing techniques. And it is aimed, okay, of turning an attacker's strength and momentum against himself. So kung kanina yung karate, okay, force, okay, pinapwersa mo siya. Eto ngayon, yung power talaga, okay, na pag-atake mo, nanggagaling sa kalaban mo. You use your opponent's strength against him. Okay? Pressure on vital nerve centers are also used. So, may mga pressure point dun yan ang tinatamaan o tinitira, okay, to incapacitate, okay, or to defeat your opponent. Aikido practitioners train to subdue rather than maim or kill. Okay, so pampigil talaga siya, but many of its movement can nevertheless be deadly. Remember, okay, pressure point ang ginagamit dyan. So there are some points in your body kung saan maaaring makapatay. Okay, so they're also careful about that. Aikido especially emphasizes the importance of achieving complete mental calm and control of one's own body to master an opponent's attack. So, hindi ito nakafocus na parang gigil na gigil ka. Kalmado ka. Kalma. Kalma ka lang. Okay? As in other martial arts, the development of courtesy and respect is an integral part of Aikido training. Now, so the basic skills of Aikido probably originated in Japan in about the 14th century. In the early 20th century, they were systematized in their modern form through the work of the Japanese martial art expert, okay, Ueshiba Morihei. Okay. There are no offensive moves in Aikido, as taught by Ueshiba. Okay. It was so purely defensive, okay, an art that no direct contest between practitioner was possible. So, para siyang kata lang, okay? Para siyang nagme-meditate lang talaga before. Okay, then later, a student of Ueshiba, Tomiki Kenji, okay, developed a competition style known as the Tomiki Aikido that incorporated Aikido techniques. Okay. A competitor, so paano ba gamitin, paano ba ang paglalaban in Aikido? So gaya na nabanggit ko kanina, nang na-develop ang Aikido is for more on self-development at for defense lang kasi gagamitin mo yung kalaban, power ng kalaban mo against him, hindi talaga sa'yo. So, hindi ito talaga nagkakaroon ng direct competition. But, Kenji, okay, developed the Tomiki Aikido. Kumbaga, para rin pwede magkaroon ngayon ng competition. So, paano ito ginagawa? A competitor attempts to score points by swiftly touching an opponent with rubber or wooden knife. Okay? Rubber na lang, delikado. Kasi sabihin mong wooden yan, tatagos pa rin sa katawan natin yan. Okay, and other tries to avoid and disarm an attacker. The two alternate in wielding the knife. Okay, so eto ngayon ang competition ngayon, hindi talaga paglalaban. Parang pagalingan ng demonstration kung paano i-apply yung techniques in Aikido. Next, we have Judo. Okay. Gusto niyo mag-judo? Hindi pwede, kailangan natin ang mating dyan eh. Okay, so judo is a Japanese martial arts. Focus on grappling, okay, grappling joint locks and throws. Punches and kicks are generally not practiced. So, wala itong punch, walang sipa. Okay, more on binabalibay yung mga locking system. Judo was created in Japan in 1880s and grew out of the even older Japanese martial arts of Jujutsu. According to the International Judo Federation, the history of Judo is the history of the shift from martial arts to modern sport. So moreover, Judo is considered a parent to newer martial arts such as Sambo and the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. So let's continue. So that's Judo. So remember, wala talaga ito. When you talk about judo, wala itong sipa, walang suntok, walang chop-chop. More on lock, okay? Nilalock o kaya yung ipinabalibag. So, what are the common judo techniques? Okay? Ito. Yung pag judo throw, yung inihahagis, they call it the nagewasa. Okay? Judo throw, okay? Using the hand, tewasa. Okay? Okay, hip technique, yung ginagamit ang hips sa pag-throw, the koshiwasa. Judo throws, foot technique, ibig sabihin, hindi mo siya sinisipa, ginagamit mo yung paa mo para ibalibag siya. Okay, it's called the ashiwasa. Okay. Sutemewasa is, okay, sacrifice technique. Katamewasa, judo grappling technique. Okay, paghawak grappling. Saewasa, judo pinning technique. Okay. Okay. Shimiwasa, judo choking technique. Ayan, okay? Ganyan yung parang hawak-hawak mo siya ng leeg mong ganyan hanggang sa makatulog or mag-tap out. Okay, and Kensetsuwasa, joint lock technique. Yung mga nilalock ng mga joints, hindi na makagalan. Okay? Try natin pag-aralan yung mga ganyan, okay? Okay, so those are the different techniques in judo. Okay, Next martial arts we have Taekwondo. Everyone is familiar with this kind of martial arts. So Taekwondo, it's a Korean art of unarmed combat that is based on the earlier form of Korean self-defense known as the Taekwondo and on Karate. Okay, so the name Taekwondo was officially adopted for this martial arts in 1955. After that, name had been submitted by the South Korean General Chung Hong-hee, the principal founder of Taekwondo. So, siya pala ang may pasimuno ng Taekwondo. Si Chung Hong-hee. So, Taekwondo is characterized by the extensive use of high standing and jump kicks as well as punches and is practiced for sport, self-defense, and spiritual development. Okay? Papahapyawan ko lang to kasi ito ang PE4 naman eh. So, training in Taekwondo is carried out by learning individual techniques of kicking, punch, and block. Okay, although pag-aaralan nyo rin yung mga basics nito, which are practiced in combined series of techniques in traditional sets known as yung. Okay, so students also practice basic sparring combination. Okay, the ibdyut-teron or one-step sparring. These are short, set of sequences of attack and counter practice between partners, after which the students may practice free sparring as opponents. In sparring, blows are stopped just short of contact. Taekwondo is practiced as a sport by awarding points to correctly execute techniques during the free sparring or by judging the quality of performance. Okay? So Taekwondo became an Olympic medal sport in the year 2000 Sydney Games. So dati wala pong hindi kasama Taekwondo sa Olympic Games. Then in the year 2000, isinama na po siya. Next, Jiu-Jitsu. Okay, so ganyang kakalabasan. Okay, so Jiu-Jitsu, okay, is a form of martial arts, okay, and a method of fighting that makes up, okay, the use of few or no weapons and employs hold, throws, and paralyzing blows to subdue an opponent. So parang similar siya ng konti sa judo. It evolved among the warrior class, the bushi or the samurai in Japan from about the 17th century, okay, and it is designed to complement warriors' swordsmanship in combat. It was a necessary ruthless style with the usual object of warfare. So, medyo brutal pag sinabi mong jiu-jitsu. So, jiu-jitsu was a general name for many systems of fighting involving techniques of hitting, kicking, kneeing, throwing, choking, immobilizing holds, and the use of certain weapons. So, sa jiu-jitsu, okay, pwede kang gumamit ng weapon. Kadalasan ang ginagamit ng weapon sa jiu-jitsu is either a sword, staff, or a spear. So, central to this system was the concept Ju from a Chinese character commonly interpreted as gentle-do. Gentle, however, in the sense of bending or yielding to an opponent's direction of attack while attempting to control it. Okay. Also, it involves the use of hand or hard or tough parts of the body. Okay. So, ano ba yung mga matitigas na pwedeng pang tira dyan? Knuckles, okay, knuckles, fist, elbows, knees, okay, and against an enemy's vulnerable parts. Jiu-Jitsu declined, okay, medyo bumabaro yung use nito after the Satsuma Rebellion of 1877. But it was enjoyed, okay, renewed popularity since the 1990s. Okay, so next, yeah, Kung Fu, yeah. Okay, so Kung Fu, okay, or a martial arts both a form of exercise with a spiritual dimension stemming from concentration and self-discipline and primarily unarmed mode of personal combat, often equated with karate or taekwondo. The technique Kung Fu can also signify careful preparation or performance of any skillful endeavor, okay, interference from the intellectual or emotional. Well, basically, when you talk about Kung Fu, more on parang exercise to or a form of meditation. And it tries to mimic, okay, because it tries to mimic animal movements. Okay, so as martial arts, Kung Fu can be traced to the Zhou dynasty, okay, and even earlier. As exercise, it was practiced by the Taoists, okay, in the 5th century BC. Its prescribed stances and actions are based on keen observation of human skeletal and muscular anatomy and physiology. So, depending pinag-aaralan yung movement ng katawan din. And it employs great muscular coordination. The various movements in Kung Fu, most of which are imitation of fighting styles of animals, that was sinabi ko, di ba? Are initiated, okay, from one of basic foot position, posture, and four stances. Okay, so, ano ba yung mga animal na originally na pinagmulan yan? Okay, starting with the dragon style, frog style, horse style martial arts, ha? Okay, riding, horse style riding, and snake style. Okay. So, there are hundreds of styles in Kung Fu, and armed as well as unarmed techniques have been developed. In the later half of the 20th century, a new genre of action films, okay, centered on Kung Fu techniques and philosophies emerged, okay, and helped promote the international interest in the art. So, nagkaroon siya na. So, by applying it, okay, in movie and entertainment, nagkaroon ngayon ng more interest, okay, sa art na ito. Okay, so we're now next to Muay Thai. Muay Thai, so it's a martial arts, ha? Baka may nasaisip niyo, parang military siya. Okay, Muay Thai, which translates to Thai boxing, is the national sport of Thailand. So, saan ang galing? Thailand. It is a martial arts with roots origin from the military use dating back to around the 13th century during the time of Sukhothai Kingdom. Ano ka pinido rin yung kingdom eh. Okay, so Muay Thai is known as the art of eight limbs because it makes use of the eight points of contact, namely punches, elbows, knees, and kicks. This differs it from other stand-up combat sports such as boxing, okay, and karate. So today, Muay Thai is practiced and competed not only in Thailand but also all around the world. Okay, next, ito. Let's slow down. Tai Chi. Okay, so Tai Chi. So we call it soft martial arts. Okay. Tai Chi Chuan, distinctively a Chinese form of exercise or attack and defense that is popular throughout the world and is closely related to ancient Taoist system of Qigong. As exercise, Tai Chi Chuan is designed to provide relaxation. Okay, slow down. Okay, mellow lang. Okay, in the process of body conditioning, exercises and is drawn from the principles of Tai Chi, notably including and harmonizing of the yin and yang. Okay, sabi natin, mabagal yan. Okay, you try moving yourself. Okay, moving yourself. Parang slow motion. Kala nyo madali. Mahirap po siya. Okay? Malisopsima. But maintaining that posture or that base is very hard. It employs flowing, okay, rhythmic deliberate movements with carefully prescribed stances and position. But in practice, no two masters teaches the system exactly alike. As a mode of attack, okay, and defense, Tai Chi Chuan, okay, resembles Kung Fu and is properly considered a martial arts. It may be used with or without weapon. So, sword, staff, or spear. Freehand exercise to promote health was practiced in China as early as the 3rd century and by the 5th century. Monks at the Buddhist monastery of Shaolin, Shaolin, okay, were performing exercises, okay, emulating the five creatures, So the bear, the bird, deer, monkey, and tiger. The snake was later added by the early Ming Dynasty in 1368. The yin and yang principles had been added to harmonize the whole. Okay? The yin and the yang, the push and the pull, the hard and the soft. Okay? An assimilation of this development, the art of Tai Chi Chuan was codified and named in the early Qing Dynasty. Okay, let's go closer to home now. Arnis. So Arnis was developed, okay, by the indigenous populations of the Philippines. Yay, go Philippines! Okay, who use an assorted range of weaponry for combat and self-defense, encompassing both simple impact and edged weapons. Arnis traditionally involves rattan, swords, dagger, and spear. Okay, yung rattan yun yung ahoy, ha? Actually, rattan ang usually ginagamit, pero ang pinakamagandang gamitin yan is called kamagong. In 1521, equipped with nothing more than bladed weapons and their fearsome Arnis abilities, Filipino islanders defeated Ferdinand Magellan's armored, musket-bearing Spanish conquistador forces when they arrived to invade. So, according to this, okay, in 1521, when Magellan, okay, tried to enter, okay, the Philippines, okay, ang pinangharap nila sa atin ay mga may barel. Okay, yung musket bearing, yun yung ano, pagkaputok mo ng ganyan, okay, lalagyan mo ng pulbura, lalagyan mo ng bearing, yan, susunod, tatatakin mo bago mo i-barel ulit. Ay, yung mga ancestors natin, ang hawak naman, ay mga arnis. Sige, sige, magtaktak ka dyan, taktakin mo yung baril mo, tatatakin ka naman namin ng arnis. Okay, so when the Spanish eventually returned and successfully conquered parts of the Philippines, the tradition of arnis were preserved despite of its prohibition. Okay, so nung makonquer na Pilipinas, walang mga pag-aral ng arnis daw, pero patago na rin yan. Okay, so para hindi halata na nagpa-practice ng arnis, okay, ginawa nila para siyang ritual dance, okay, at perform, at parang may mock battle. So ginawa nila kunyari entertainment, okay, parang nagde-demo-demo, pero practice na pala yun. Okay, while earlier Filipino martial arts were influenced by Spanish colonization, the modern forms have been affected by the country's contact with both the United States and Japan after gaining independence in 1898. Just over a century later, in 2009, the government of the Philippines declared arnis to be the martial arts and national sport of the Philippines. So, yan ha? Arnis is otherwise known as eskrima, kali, and garote. Okay, and by even more names in different Filipino regional languages. Although Spanish influence had a pacifying effect on Filipino martial arts culture, the original warrior ethos has persisted and remained on the fringes of the art. Arnis death marches were outlawed, okay, as late as 1951, yet, as Mark B. Wiley explained, in Filipino martial arts culture, they still take place in private today. Okay? Death marches, right? So parang fight club. So the Philippine government's declaration of arnis, the national sport, has codified a clear martial arts culture. This should begin to develop an accessible story of Filipino cultural heritage that the outside world can grasp, like Japan did during the Edo period, okay, and as post-cultural revolution China has done with Wushu. Okay, so that is the end of our topic. So at least nagkaroon kayo ng insight, okay, patungo sa iba't ibang types of martial arts. Yes, there are still a lot of different martial arts out there, okay, but at least this is the most common. So thank you for listening and have a nice day.